Hello musicians, thank you for joining us. My name is Andrew Mercer, and in this tutorial I'm going to be addressing one of the biggest challenges that the vocalists have when recording vocal tracks. Now this challenge, this issue, comes from many subscribers that I've had in both YouTube as well as on my blog, andrewmercer.ca. And that is, why do my vocals sound muddy? How can I get my vocals to sound clearer, with more volume? It's always a little too quiet. These are questions that come up often from vocalists who are trying to record. So let's have a look at how we can fix that problem. Now you can see here, I'm using a wide diaphragm condenser microphone for this demonstration. This is actually broken. It's just a prop. This microphone, when it was working, there's certain ways it worked well. Now I'll tell you about how this worked, and we can use that as a demonstration for how you can you work with yours. First of all, most vocalists, when they're singing, they tend to be too far away from the microphone. They'll stand back here, and there's some kind of repulsive thing that happens, and many people are afraid to get on top of the microphone. So when they stand back here and sing, the microphone is working very hard to pick up the sound, and it's in the process, it's picking up all kinds of room sound, picking up echoes off the window, it's picking up echoes off the ceiling and the floor, and it's making your recording sound muddy and not clear, and of course you're further away. So you have to crank all your settings on your software and in your hardware in order to compensate for the distance. Now in order to get away from that, you get closer to the microphone. Now if you get close to this microphone, what's going to happen is your plosives, your P's and your K's and your B's, these consonants are going to pop the microphone. It's going to cause clipping in your microphone, and we don't want that. Watch this video here. This will talk to you how to deal with plosives, how to deal with K's and P's and things like that. Now, what I'm going to do in order to fix some of that is I'm going to use a pop filter or a windscreen. That's what this is. It's a foam cover that goes over the microphone. Now, you may have seen there's also ones you can get that are screens that go in front of the microphone, usually round. If you watch this video, you'll see how to actually make your own pop filter, basically for free. Now, I got my pop screen on, my pop filter. Now, if I'm going to use this microphone, I'm going to want to be about this close. I'm going to want to be about 4 inches from this microphone. That would probably do it for this one, 4 inches. Now, you might say, well, that sounds really close. And when you get in there, it may be quite loud. That's what we want. We want the microphone to be able to do its job. It doesn't need to work so hard. And when you're this close, your microphone is going to pick up all the resonance in your head. You know, the things that, if you stand back, these kinds of sounds are lost. But when you're in close, it's going to pick up all the nuances of your chest sound and your head sound and all the nice tones that you produce, as well as the consonants and things that you're making as you produce the tone. When you're close to this to the microphone, you will get that beautiful, rich sound. And the further you move away, that sound will change. You need to explore that as well. You need to get on the microphone like this and record yourself 4 inches from it, directly into the capsule. And then listen to it, and then move 6 inches back, directly into the capsule. Listen to that back. And do A, B, and see which one you like better. Then maybe try singing a little bit off-center. So you're singing off the capsule, a little bit off the diagonal to the capsule. And try that, 2 inches, 4 inches, 6 inches, and see how that works for you. And eventually you'll find the sweet spot for your microphone. And when you do, stick to it. It's really worth it because you're going to get this big, strong sound that you want. Okay, it's going to be really rich and full. So get on that microphone, get it nice and close, and let the microphone do the work for you. Okay, if you like this, give us a like down below. Give us a thumbs up. That really helps the channel. So make sure you give us a like if you like this. And be sure to subscribe as well. We have loads of new tutorials coming up all the time, so be sure and give us a subscribe as well. Happy recording, and I'll see you guys next time.